Brer Caleb, Ph.D. Deception Protocol Simplified. Who doesn't see the humoristic side behind the problem has still not understood social democracy today. Today, I found an interesting question. Two people posted new pictures on my site to show they are different this year 2020. What is so different in your situation for 2020? Many of us want the year count. Why is that, and why do we make promises we can't keep, or are those promises we will follow? The road to hell is paved with good intentions, but in reality, what are we saying? Another question, can a Christian marry a non-Christian? What does this mean? What is so special about a Christian? Some don't care about this question, but someone posted it, and somebody is interested in the answer. My answer is straightforward. If you are a good human and you have a good solid understanding of life, then you should be able to make a clear-cut decision in matters of the heart. However, most of us are developing as we live, and when we are young, we only do what they tell you, like in my case. Teachers told me many things, and I learned that you needed to do this, and this and this on seminary, Bible school, or business courses, or business colleges, and university. And yes, I applied them. I must tell you, many issues ingrained in me by leadership, was not always right. Yes, teachers can have it wrong, I discovered the three lying spirits. Called PMS, politics, money, spirituality or religion. Pastors can have it wrong, and leaders can have it wrong. Back to the question, can a Christian marry a non-Christian? Yes, you can, but they have to understand that when you marry somebody other than your convictions, you might have a lot of growing up to do. My wife raised in a moderate Muslim environment, and I culturally raised as a Christian, for example. Both of us had convictions, both of us loved each other. Sure, out of love, we understood we had to accept each other, and that is how we carried each other through life. Did I change? Oh yes, I sure did change, because I learned from my wife what real love was. Did she change? Yes, she did, she became more independent, a person willing to stand up for what she believed in. I share with you a secret that affected others because she loved him, and through her love, we both changed, and we became a stable family that could withstand everything thrown at us. When our son passed away in my arms, our world collapsed. It was through genuine love, caring and compassion. We overcame these problems, as I gave her room to grow in her way. She let me work out my issues. I used to put a lot of energy into my work, to get rid of the pressure in my system. But it was the Spirit of God Almighty, called Ruach HaKodesh, who guided us, that best showed how to get to the wow factor. Wow, we learned how we learned to walk on water. To do the impossible, for I am more than overcomer, amen. If you want to learn how to do that, you got to learn to open your heart. Someone walked that way before us, that way was called the way. The best way is that a small path, different than the way the world uses, but it sure changes you. Are you prepared to open your heart? When you follow that little inner voice, it will make you different and dependent on the love of God. Now, we're not talking about what kind of religion I am. It has a lot to do if people recognize the love of God in my life. That is what it's all about. And if they do, fantastic, if they don't, you will discover life will not be easy for you. Brer Caleb, Ph.D. Tough times never last, tough people do.